heard something about this. I sort of understand the fascination.
That's odd. You can babysit anything.
Well, yeah. I don't think my wife would. I didn't worry the state to use the SPCA. All right. That made my day. I'll remember this a long time.
DG is almost fully recovered, and in a few weeks, he'll be found a home with a specialist adopter. Living proof that you don't always have to have four legs and be cute to be given a second chance. A month ago, Bianca was found chained, thin, and covered in fleas. She'd just given birth to three puppies, which she had hidden under a house. All were rescued by the Houston SPCA. Bianca and her family have now moved from the shelter to the home of volunteer Cynthia Haycraft. She's fostering them until they're old enough to be adopted. She likes to keep them busy.
We start out in the morning after breakfast, come running out the back door, go and take some toys and go outside in the grass or up on the porch and play around, watching them jump and learn, experience new endeavors, new places. They play with mom, they get to run around. They still like to try and catch a quick little suckle and remember that it is mom, and they have a lot of fun playing with each other, teaching each other little dog lessons.
They were born into a world of neglect and were lucky to survive.
The heat in the day and the cool at night and the weather that we've had recently here in Texas with all the rain is very bad conditions for puppies. They can get very sick and will die. Generally,